Miami artist Gerry Stecca creates installations inspired by nature and incorporates repetition and unusual objects into his artwork. But at the Deering State at Cutler, Stecca draws upon his childhood and studies in science to blend the abstract with the organic.
I do two things in my art life. I'm a sculptor and I am also a painter, even though that was put aside for a few years, but it's coming back with a vengeance. So I'm doing both right now. Not long after I began doing installations and sculptures, sort of experimenting with it, I discovered the Clothespin and made a dress that wasn't very good, but it was fun. And the attention I got made me think that maybe I should do some more things with it. And it's been about 12 years. And it's kind of mostly all I do right now. Never thought of using the plastic one. I think it's a nostalgic idea behind them. And everyone either likes them or tolerates the Clothespin. Nobody dislikes them at all. Most of the things I make are the result of something I discover in the process. So it's a process-driven result. And of course, after a while, when you really get to know the technique, then you can start doing anything you want. So I have created things that look like things. Most of it is just things that almost kind of happen. Of course, working at this park, at the Deering State, the inspiration is changing, or I am getting new inspiration from the mangrove forest and the roots in the trees and all these things. So that is coming through into the work, which is kind of one of the intentions that I had. One day, I must have seen something that made me think of wrapping a tree. Found one in a private location and I wrapped the tree. It was one of the most difficult things I ever done because I didn't have any previous experience. But that led to a series of now six projects which have involved wrapping trees. This is kind of past the raw stage. These are actually lightly stained. The tones that you see on this are from the Clothespins having been outside at different times. And then I sealed them with a wood sealer. So there is some manipulation on the finish. I really appreciate kids' opinions because the few times I titled the pieces, it has been because some child said something that no one thought of it, or they can see things that, you know, we don't see anymore because we grew up and we lost that magic. So I first listen to people and they may inspire an idea that I didn't think about, maybe it was there, or it fits so perfect that it's just right. I'm combining a lot of old techniques with new materials. I'm painting and drawing on plaster, similar process to the old fresco, which was done, it was painting on wet plaster. But nowadays there is materials that allow you to paint in the very same way, but on dry plaster, allowing you more time to work, less pressure, more flexibility on the techniques. So I'm introducing an old concept with new materials and my old love for drawing mixed into the painting. And if I get lucky, if I can figure it out, I will be using pigments and colors that I get out of the nature of the park. As soon as I made them, I realized they look like paintings of trees I have done years ago. Most of them have been inspired by trees in the area. You know, the roots and the ficus and this banyan tree especially. So they fit well with what I'm doing now. It's kind of like an old idea coming back. Both my parents are microbiologists. They studied pharmacy and then got their PhD in microbiology. So when I went to college, I wanted to be different things related to the biology environment. And now the new work looks sometimes like something you will find in a microscope because of the detail, even though they're not copied from life. I think the major inspiration is what I am getting out of it at the end. It's a little bit of a surprise, a little bit of how the piece reacts where it is at, the site where it ends up. The reaction people get is always a treat. I mean, if you're not gonna make much money, you might as well get good feedback. So I enjoy that, the interaction that people have with the work.
If you're traveling through Miami International Airport, look for Stecca's Mermaids 2 sculpture, which is currently on display near Concourses D and E. For more on this artist, enter gerrystecca.com and log on to DeeringEstate.com for information on their artist-in-residence program and upcoming art events.